हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द इंग्लिश क्लास। स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेस क्लास लेट अस रीड द लेसन द बॉय हु आस्क्ड फॉर मोर, रिटन बाय चार्ल्स डिकेंस। लेट अस नो अबाउट द ऑथर। द बॉय हु आस्क्ड फॉर मोर, रिटन बाय चार्ल्स डिकेंस। हिज पीरियड वाज फ्रॉम 1812 टू 1870। He was the greatest Victorian novelist and he is known for his attacks on social evils like child labor and institutional cruelty. Most of his writings were based on the social evils, the existing problems in the society. And his most popular works are David Copperfield, A Tale of Two Cities and Great Expectations. This extract, the lesson what you have, The Boy Who Asked for More, from Oliver Twist, tells us how Oliver was forced out of the poor house. Here Oliver is the name of a boy who plays the main character in this story. There are a few of the new words which you come across in this chapter. Hastily is urgently. A pauper woman is a poor woman. Beadle, an officer. Persuade is convince or believe something. Watery gruel is a liquid food. Some more new words here. Appetites is natural craving for food. Council is meeting. Poor house, building where poor people or children are maintained at public expense. Some orphans are taken care of, that's called as a poor house. Hardly known is almost not known. Excitement is feeling strongly. Horror, a feeling of extreme fear. Miserable is very unhappy or wretched. Invented here is coined. Starved is to go without food. Students, you can see to the page number 60 on the screen. You can refer the same in your textbook too. Here, the story begins with the birth of Oliver. Oliver is the main character of the story here. Oliver was born in a poor house of a little country town on a cold black night in the winter of 1837. The circumstances that led to the birth of Oliver. He was born in a very poor house and the season was cold. It was very cold black night in the winter. It was during the winter season he was born in 1837. And how his birth was attended by a doctor who was hastily called for this purpose, and also by an old experienced pauper woman, a poor woman who was experienced in such matters. And soon after his birth, what happened? Let us see in paragraph second. The mother died almost as soon as the baby took his first breath. So he lost his mother as soon as his birth took place. She was young, good-looking woman who had been found lying in the street. It was clear that she had walked some distance before she died. And her shoes had been torn to pieces. Where she had come from or where she had been going, nobody knew about Oliver's mother properly. The baby cried loudly after its birth. If he could have known that he was now an orphan of a poor house, it is likely that he would have cried still louder. If that baby had known that he had become a member of that orphan, he is no more with his parents, he is to live in a poor house, it would have cried in a louder, still more louder voice, says the author. They called him Oliver Twist, a name invented by Mr. Bumble, the town beadle, because he could not think of any other. So, what was the baby named as? The baby was named as Oliver Twist. And who named the baby? It was Mr. Bumble. He was a town beadle. Beadle is an officer. And because he could not think of any other name, Mr. Bumble had full authority over the people of the poor house. So that orphanage or that poor house was under the control of Mr. Bumble. He thought of himself as a great man, but how was the situation of the children in that poor house? He starved and ill-treated the children under his care. Oliver's ninth birthday found him a pale, thin child who had hardly known a kind word or met with a kindly look. Now, how was he in the poor house? At the age of 9 years, he found himself very pale. When his birthday took place at the age of 9, he was a very pale and a thin child. He didn't even know a word of kindness because all he had seen was cruelty there. His only friends were his little companions in misery. But in the end, they brought him trouble. They persuaded him to ask for more. So what happened? His only companions in that poor house were few friends who always, though they also lived in that misery, that poorness. But at the end, those friends themselves brought him trouble. And how was the trouble brought to him? They persuaded him to ask for more. And what was that? They insisted him to ask for more. Let us read further. It happened one evening at supper time. The children were fed in a large stone hall with a big metal basin at one end. So, one supper time, evening, the dinner what you have at night is called as the supper. The children were fed. How was this environment, where they used to have their food was? They were fed in a large stone hall. It was a large room with a big metal basin at the end. One big vessel would have been kept. And the master stood by the basin and served each child with a small bowl of watery gruel. There was a master who used to stand by and serve the children. And the food what was given was watery gruel. That means a liquid food. It was not the hard food what they could eat. Full meals per day. Boys generally have excellent appetites. Boys naturally have more hunger for food. Oliver and his companions were also hungry and never given enough to eat. Those boys in the poor house, they were not fed properly. And that evening what happened? One of the bigger boys stated quite clearly, he told with the others that unless he had an extra bowl of gruel, he would almost certainly eat the boy who slept next to him. So the bigger boy who was there, he started telling that if his hunger is not satisfied, he would eat away the small boy who is sleeping next to him. He had a wild and hungry eye. So the smaller boys believed him. They were scared looking at that boy. So a council was held. A council means a meeting was held among those boys itself. And they, what did they do? They appointed Oliver Twist to walk up to the master after supper and to ask for more. So all the boys decided that it was Oliver who would go to the master and ask for more gruel. So after the discussion among the boys that Oliver would go and ask for more gruel, so the gruel was served out and was quickly swallowed. The boys had drank the food what was given. And the boys whispered among themselves and forced Oliver to go to the master. So Oliver advances towards the master with a bowl in his hand and he said in a little frightened voice, "Please, sir, I want some more." So the master was a fat, healthy man. But he turned pale at this. "What?" he said, as if he could not believe his ears. "Please, sir, I want some more." So there was a pleading voice from Oliver wanting for some more food. But the master was a very cruel person. He just asked in a stern voice, "What was it?" So the master aimed a blow at his head, seized him by his arms and shouted for the beetle. By the time Oliver requested for the more food, the master gave him a big blow on his head, took him by his arms and shouted. He called for the officer. Mr. Bumble rushed into the room in great excitement and was filled with horror when he heard of Oliver's crime. So what exactly was Oliver's crime? Asking for more food. It was a crime in that poor orphanage. "Asked for more?" he exclaimed. "I never heard of such a thing. Depend on it, this miserable boy will be hung." So the beadle shouts at the boy saying that, "I have never heard such a thing," because until then none of the boys living in that poor house had raised their voice or asked for more food. And Oliver's asking for more food had become a big crime. And for that, the officer said that he would be hung. As a punishment for his greed and boldness, Oliver was immediately locked in a room to spend the night alone. Just because Oliver asked for more food, he was locked up in a room to spend the night alone. All alone by himself. Very early the next morning, what was seen is a notice was pasted on the gate outside the orphanage. The notice stated that A reward of 5 pounds would be given to any man or woman who would take Oliver Twist off the hands of the poor house. Like if anybody would adopt Oliver or take him home by themselves, any man or woman, they would be given a reward of 5 pounds from the orphanage. So here, asking for more gruel by Oliver became a crime. Let's see how the story of Oliver Twist ends up. So after that notice was pasted on the gate, a coffin maker came to know about the notice and bought the orphan boy from the poor house. So a coffin maker, one who makes boxes which keeps the dead body. So that person takes Oliver to his house. And there also he was treated cruelly. Even that man treated Oliver very cruelly. So what did he do? He ran away to London. And there he faced further difficulties of life. However, by chance in his life, he met two kind people. That is Mr. Brownlow and Miss Rosie Maylie. There, these kind people also discovered that he was their own relative. And Oliver became the relative of those two people. And they also had to protect him from his stepbrother, Mr. Monks. So Oliver had a stepbrother, Mr. Monks. And Mr. Monks had planned to take away Oliver's share of property. But with the help of Mr. Brownlow, Oliver got his rightful share of his property and lived happily thereafter.